Hello everyone, it's The Trial back with a brand new video, and today we are going to be reacting to the brand new album I Disagree by none other than Poppy. Now, I first got into Poppy December 2016. I found her on Twitter, and then I started watching her music videos, and then I discovered she started making these weird social commentary videos about celebrity and fame, and they were like really cryptic and like eerie and scary. Well, for me, not personally, but for like people on the outside, like people were genuinely fucking scared of Poppy. As soon as someone starts doing shit like that, like they have this whole character and persona and just way of doing things in like this strong artistic direction, it just like instantly gets me hooked, because that's literally what I look for in artists and musicians. I started paying attention to her and following her along in her career. So she had the Bubble Bath EP, which came out way before I got into her. It came out in like May of that year, May 2016. I started following her all throughout 2017. I was watching all of her videos. She would upload all her creepy videos. And that's when she was like basically on the rise of becoming like a pop star, basically.
Am I gonna be okay? The internet makes sense to me. Everything in your life is perfect. What do you have to worry about? It's okay. I think everything's gonna be fine. I believe that everything's okay.
In that year, 2017, she came out with her debut album called poppy.computer. And this album was very experimental in the Poppy character and persona. She was very computer and electronic and futuristic driven. So that is what this album primarily consisted of. Made metaphors about floppy disks, putting your floppy disk in my hard drive, and just P-O-P-P-Y, like very digital and just robotic music, right? And not necessarily the kind of robotic music that I like. So that's why I didn't really enjoy this album. I wasn't the biggest fan of poppy.computer. The only songs like My Style and Where's My Microphone, I think it's called, were the songs that stood out to me. And this album was produced by, put out by Diplo's label Mad Descent. So I think she signed with them at this time. And then after the whole poppy.computer era, her second album came out. And prior to that album release, she came out with a song called Metal. And we're like, ooh, this is kind of new for Poppy. She's not very like computer-ish and like cutesy and pink and kawaii Japan. She's now darker and edgier. And we're like, ooh, what? Is this like a character change? Is this artistic growth? What is going on here with Miss Poppy? And she released Single X, which came out after Metal. And this was Poppy's like big like artistic turn. Like no one was expecting this to come from Poppy. Her song, Gimme, Gimme Bloody, Please Gimme Bloody. She was, you can get down on your knees if you're naughty. Merging rock and metal songs, and then she would sing that in the chorus, and then right after the chorus it'd be like na 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 na. Please take me back to where we began. So she was just like on her own developing this weird ass fucking mixed genre sound for herself, and I'm so proud, because like that to me is just like amazing when an artist can literally come up with their own shit that no one knows how to digest unless you just get it. And I feel like I'm one of those people that just get it and just accept it. And I feel like because I was like one of her fans, right? I wasn't like a wishy-washy person, and I'm all here for artistic and personal growth and people changing their sound and doing stuff that they feel is more suitable for their pathway in life. On the album, she has a few pop songs like Aristocrat and I'm Working and Fashion After All. And she also had a song called Play Destroy, which is kind of like a new metal song with Grimes. She collabed with Grimes. There was some mess and feud going on after that. So then they parted ways. They unfollowed each other. Oh, I don't even want to, whatever. Poppy starts getting more heavy, more metal music. And she releases an EP. And then on this EP, there's songs called Scary Mask, Choke, I don't remember the other songs, So we're like, okay, Poppy's really establishing herself as this new metal artist. This is like the genre, this is the direction she's going into, right? She's more like dive into like the metal community, and just like, if you go watch on YouTube, you can see a whole bunch of like metal heads and metal people that stand metal music reacting to her shit and just like not knowing how to fucking digest it, because they're so used to just pure metal. And what Poppy does is she fucking has metal hooks and guitars and everything, but at the same time, she doesn't lose who she originally was. She has her cutesy, like I said, kawaii moments, soft like pop music combined with the metal. And of course the metal heads and pop heads are gonna be like, ew, what the fuck is this? This is not real metal. This is not this. Well, sucks for them, because this girl is literally genre pushing. She considers her music post-genre, and I feel like I can consider it that too, considering that she just mixes a bunch of shit together and there's not really anything to fucking call it at the end of the day. So yeah, Poppy had a longtime collaborator named Titanic Sinclair, and this guy was the one who was orchestrating like all her weird videos and like creating the Poppy persona. But like behind the scenes, what we didn't know he was going on, he was abusive, he was manipulative and everything. And Poppy literally just came out with this whole statement concerning how she parted ways with him, she's done with him, talked about all this bad shit he's done. I'm not gonna get into it because I don't want to give him more clout than he needs. So now Poppy's by herself, she's killing the game, she's making genre pushing fucking music, and I'm just so proud of her growth. And so many people, the thing that annoys me about Poppy's fans and people that like casually listen to her, they loved her Bubble Bath EP, right? Where Money, The Altar, Low Life, her first single Low Life, and this, like I said, I don't know if I said this, but it was more palatable pop music, and a lot of like pop stans and pop gays, whatever, love this sound from Poppy, and they wanted her to continue making this music. But she herself knew this is not the kind of music she wanted to make. She wanted to make metal leaning music. She said recently in an interview that this is the music she's always loved and her collaborators always loved. So this is the kind of music that she wanted to push for herself and wanted to be her brand and what she identifies with creatively, right? After her EP, now she revealed that she's coming out with an album called I Disagree, and the lead single, I believe, was Concrete. See, at this point, sis is going full heavy. Sis is not looking back on her past at all. And I'm just literally so fucking proud of her. As I was saying, the pop was like, oh, when you pop, you go back to her sound. Oh, Poppy's own music would be... These are the people who are just so stuck on one fucking genre. They don't know how to expand their fucking taste at all. They don't know how to be open to new music. And what you're doing is you're trying to pull someone back from growing for the sake of your own taste. If you really like the person, let them grow. You don't have to listen to them anymore, but stop begging them to go back to what they used to make. That's just like, I was a big Natalia Kills stan when I was fucking 11 years old, right? And Natalia Kills as a singer and artist and persona ended along with when she did the whole X Factor shit, and she basically killed the artist known as Natalia Kills. She killed it. And then what did she do? She came back as Cruel Youth. And now she makes more alternative music, not so much dark pop. And personally, me, I have to accept that. I'm not going to harass her and be like, oh, can you go back to the dark pop? Natalia Kills, blood, sex, violence, tie you up. That girl is a problem. Superficial bitch. Fucking just another Saturday night. I'm not going to ask her to fucking go back to that music, because I respect her as an artist and I respect her personal growth and the new direction she decides to take her career. And that's what Poppy fans and casual listeners should do, or just don't listen to the artist at all. But stop harassing people to go back on their fucking past and tap into something that they clearly moved on from. Like, that's annoying. We're about to get into this album. This album is highly anticipated for me. It's only 10 songs. I love short-ass albums. I love albums that are only, like, 10 songs. It's just such easy listening and fluid. Straight to the point. No filler. The album is only 35 fucking minutes long. Perfect. Okay, so you guys know the drill. You know what I'm about to do before I listen to the song, and I'll be back after I snap my fingers. I'm back. So now it is time to get into this fucking album. How many stuff has Poppy came out with? So, Bubble Bath EP 2016. EP, Poppy Computer album 2017, Am I a Girl 2018, The Mountain EP 2019. She has three albums and two EPs, and this is only the beginning for her in her career. That's so insane to me. And she just shown so much fucking artistic growth. Therefore, I have to love her. I have to stan. Like, you have to stan Poppy. Like, I'm sorry for the people that are not here for her fucking taste. I mean, her development of her fucking Poppy persona. But just, like, I don't give a fuck. Poppy is it. I love her. I love... The reason why I'm here for her artistic direction, because I do love rock and metal music, because what the fuck was the number one thing I loved when I was a kid? Professional wrestling. Therefore, what video games that I play and had to get every single year when I was a kid till this day? Professional wrestling. And now in recent years, they're more hip-hop music, but all old wrestling game was just rock and metal music, and that was literally what was just fed into my brain 25/8. On top of that, I liked Bratz Rock Angels, and like that fucking formed my taste and gave me, I guess, that was the gay side of the rock, Bratz Rock Angels, if you want to give credit to that. Track number one is Concrete. Now, Concrete came out months ago. I don't remember the time, but Concrete was literally a standout. Like, I love this song. So, like, I'm just so excited to listen to it right now. All right. I Disagree, starting now. Okay, so for Concrete, bitch, I'm done with that number since that was the most dumbest thing I think I've ever fucking came up with on this channel in my life. That fucking Concrete as an opening track, that is just Poppy. When I hear that, that's what Poppy is. She's that bury me 6 feet deep and na 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 na, come in concrete. That is who she is. And I just feel like that song captures her perfectly. Not Concrete. If I had to number it, I would give that a fucking 5. I'm numbering. I just said I'm not fucking numbering. What the fuck am I doing? I think that was the first single for this album, actually. Yeah, it was. And then she announced I Disagree coming January 2020. Anyways, yep. That was the song. I love that song. Perfect. The next song is I Disagree. Now, I think this was the second single. This might have been the second single for this album. And this song is a bop too. I love it. Let's get into it. Okay, that was amazing. That's the title track of the fucking album. That's a bop. Oh my god, my head. Oh, her face hurt. The next song is called Blood Money. Now, she released this after I Disagree. This was the third single. What do you believe when everyone is watching? What do you believe? Poppy ate that, but like, are we surprised? Holy fuck, where do we even begin? So that is definitely like the whole new metal futuristic sound Poppy is like literally the face of. So yeah, Blood Money, they had all those fucking electronic distortion glitchy shit that Miss Charlie XCX did at the end of Click, mixed with fucking... perfection. I love that electronic music and those metal and rock guitars, and just when you mix them together and just go yes, yes, yes. So the next song, track number 4, is Anything Like Me. First of all, it literally gave me black skinhead tees, which I was caught off guard because I love that. That's definitely a fucking shoo-in for literally one of my top songs on this album. That is just, wow, brilliant. Because she added that fucking, the do-do-do-do-do. But at the end of that, she brought in the fucking guitars. The next song is track number 5, which is Feel the Crown. This was the final single, I believe, from this album. Yeah, she just released this a month ago, maybe, or so. And this, for sure, I didn't really listen to. I watched the music video just, like, a couple seconds, but I didn't, like, get into it because I wanted to save it for the album. I'm gonna pause it. This was the song that sounded like fucking Marilyn Manson. It literally sounds like Marilyn Manson, but I Twitter searched it. I'm like, Poppy, Marilyn Manson. Everyone was like speculating, but they said it's some guy from, I don't know who he is, but it's just not Marilyn Manson. It was this other guy, but he sounds literally so similar. And like, Marilyn Manson was following Poppy and Poppy was following Marilyn. Like, that collab needs to fucking happen. It needs to happen. Feel the Crown, that was a cute girl. I love the guy is not even credited as the collaborator, whoever it is, but literally it sounds like Marilyn Manson. So like, in my pretend, I'm gonna just pretend it's Poppy Marilyn Manson, but that dun 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 in the first probably like 20 seconds, that's just the classic fucking rock riff. That literally just brought me back to all the fucking wrestling games, because it's literally all the music they would have in them, as well as fucking Rock Band too. Rock Band was literally a game I was in love with when I was a fucking child, and all of the songs on there literally introduced me to all these fucking classic rock bands and just rock music, like knowing the actual names and like titles of songs. Track number 6 is Nothing I Need. I'm gonna be honest, not my favorite. It was just boring to me. It kind of reminded me of like old Poppy. Just no excitement for me personally. That, like I'm saying, that's just my taste. Yeah, that wasn't doing it for me. Next song, track number 7, is Sit/Stay. So is it Sit/Stay? Is it Sit/Stay? Or is it Sit/Stay? We don't know. All we know is that we're about to get into it right now. That sounds like Sophie in her Oil of Ebony Pearls and Insides Nonstop Remix album. Is it Ecstasy Axe? XTC Acid? The two. Like, you know what I'm talking about. what it sounds like. That's what it reminded me of. So the only parts that I liked about was the song was just that instrumental. Sounds like 2003 PS2 car chase soundtrack. I tried to vibe to the chorus. It was just something that was offbeat about. Like, I tried to catch on the beat. I tried to ride the wave and I just couldn't. I didn't really click with that song other than that. Like I said, that one part that reminds me of a PS2 game, which was fucking dope. Yeah, that song didn't really do it for me. I don't think that'll be a grower. That will just stay as it is. Track number 8 is called Bite Your Teeth. That sounds scary and interesting. I hope it's a really heavy song. Classic poppy switch up. Okay, so Bite Your Teeth, that was amazing in the sense that you just never knew where the fuck it was gonna go next. Boom. Like, it started, I'm like, I hope the song is heavy, Bite Your Teeth. As soon as I play it, just, like, punches you in the fucking face. And then she did the classic poppy switch up where it's just lullabies, laying in a grass field, having no fucks to give. And back into the heavy shit. Brilliant. Fucking brilliant. Track number 9, Sick of the Sun. Miss Poppy did that with I'm sick of the sun. And with the fucking trap drum in the back. That drum and beat saved the fucking song from another snooze fest. And I have to plug in that in her song. That was a good fucking choice on whoever's end. Her end. Who made that decision. Last track of the album is Don't Go Outside. Now this is the album's closer and chow. Fucking title sounds heavy as shit. Don't go outside, bitch. Why can't I go outside? I'm gonna be monsters. Why the fuck can I not go outside? Yes, I disagree. Damn. That was a lot in that last one. That last song was 6 minutes and 6 seconds long now. It was kind of boring for me in the majority of the song until the ending, bitch. That ending where she blended Concrete. I disagree. I don't know. I think she maybe had another song thrown in there. I knew this song. I just don't remember the title right now. She blended all that shit together. She re-fucking mixed I Disagree down. Let it all burn down. Burn it to the ground. We'll be safe and sound. Okay. So to conclude, this album was cute. My favorite fucking songs on it is Anything Like Me, Concrete, I Disagree, and Bite Your Teeth. Those are my, and Sick of the Song, Sick of the Sun. Those songs are just my tops. The one that I would have to like the least would be, I think it was Nothing I Need. Or since it was one of those that was just a snooze fest for me. I wasn't into it at all. So yeah, Poppy's album, I Disagree. She's going on tour. She's coming to Toronto February 2nd. I might just have to go by myself because no one else likes this hoe. Yeah. I love Poppy. I love that she just takes leaps and fucking huge adventures with her career. She's literally the face of what they call new metal and just basically post-genre music. Music that you can't put a fucking cap on it because it can't have a cap because, like, it's just not one thing. There's nothing to fucking call it yet. And to be honest, I love music like that when there's nothing to call it because it's like a literal fucking artistic free-for-all, bitch. You could do whatever the fuck you want. And to me, someone like Poppy is literally a pioneer in fucking music. A pioneer fucking year. She is at the forefront of this whole entire fucking transformation that a lot of people don't even know is happening. Don't be surprised if your favorite music artist in a few years from now, we're going to be start experimenting with shit this girl been doing now and been doing. All right, that was the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. Stick around for this fuckery. Like this video, comment, subscribe. My Instagram and Twitter is at gunshot with H-A-W-T instead of O-T. O-T-O-T. Thank you so much for watching and stream I Disagree and support Poppy because she's important to the music industry. Then you think.